Welcome back to day two of the 2019 Wftda International Playoffs here at the Kent Showwear Center, hosted by Rat City Roller Derby. I am Julia Sleezer, and I am joined here by Rat City's own Murray Grande.
It was an exciting day yesterday for day one of the 2019 International Wftda Playoffs here in Seattle. Everything, though, the results-wise, went pretty true to seeding. We had started off with Stockholm Roller Derby versus Arizona, the number nine seed versus number eight seed. Arizona went ahead. And then Minnesota versus the hometown Rat City Roller Derby. Rat City advanced to the finals. In the quarterfinals, Denver, the number one seed, was victorious over Arizona. Crime City from Malmo. It was neck and neck, back and forth with Rat City. However, the number four seed did go on ahead to victory over the hometown league.
And then otherwise, we had London Roller Derby face off against Queen City Roller Girls, which was a pretty close game for a long time also. London pulled out victorious about 70 points. So they went on, or they're going to go on, to play Philly Roller Derby here in about 8 minutes. And then we had Jacksonville Roller Derby, New Jack City, face off against Ann Arbor Roller Derby. Jacksonville came out victorious on that, so they will be facing off for our second game today at 12 o'clock Pacific against Montreal, which is our seed number two. And then for our consolation brackets, what do you have?
We have two consolation games today at 2 p.m. local time, 5 p.m. Eastern. Stockholm will be taking on Queen City. And then a couple of hours later, Derby Standard Time at 4 p.m. or 7 p.m. Minnesota taking on Ann Arbor.
All right, if you would like to check out more detailed statistics on the games that have happened this weekend or in general, you can check stats.wftda.com. And thank you so much for joining us today.
Welcome to the 2019 International WFTDA Playoffs from Seattle, Washington. I am Scott Chicken, joined by Muffin Tumble.
Hi.
We had a lovely day yesterday, Muffin.
Super
I enjoyed
busy.
Myself.
I had a great first day of this tournament.
It was a good time.
Lovely.
And hopefully you were able to tune in if you were at work, sneak that in on the laptop on the side. We are here for our third quarterfinal game between the number three seed Philly Roller Derby, Liberty Bells. They are ranked number nine in the world versus the number six seed London Roller Derby, London Brawling. London ranked number 17 in the world. How do we get here? We have Philly has a bye, so they get to, this is their first game of the tournament.
They're coming in fresh legs and feet, ready to go. They're going to work hard. London had a great day yesterday. They won 201 to 136 against Queen City to get here today.
Queen City playing a tough game yesterday. That was dicey in the first half. It was very close, and then London kind of pulling away in the second half. We did, if you tuned into the Twitch game yesterday, you will have seen an interview with a couple of the Philly skaters. Their airplane struck by lightning. And the question was raised, were there any superpowers acquired? And I don't know if it was telling, but the hint was, you'll have to tune in today to see. So we'll find out.
And I think we all know VD already has superpowers, even before the lightning.
100% guaranteed superpowers. Shall we talk about some rosters? We'll run through, should we do London first? What the heck? We'll do London first. All right, skating four, London Brawling from the London Roller Girls. Number zero, Jack Attack. Number 020 is Sable. Number 08, Hump Me. 1236 is Madge. 129, Just Jess. Number 16, Drac. Number 4, Delta Strike. Number 42, Trisha Smackanawa. Number 6 is Ramit. Number 7, Kitty. 8008 is Gaz. Number 81, Inky Minx. 84, Katie Helvetica Black. Number 888, Shaylin Scarlet. Sholin Scarlet, rather, excuse me. Number 9 is Beth Lord, and they are supported on the bench by Aura, Eamon, Dottie, and Fright Meow.
All right, and skating in black, we have your Philly Roller Derby, Liberty Bells. 00, Meryl Stripper. 15, Persephone. 152, Herman. 18, Vanessa, V. Diva Sites. 1818, Anne Frankenstein. 21, Tramagotchi. 29, Steph Leopard. 34, Jail Bars. 45, Built to Spill. 501, Reptar. 66, Little Loca. 85, Teflon Donna. 902, Rousey. 957, gingivitis, and 99, Russian Bayou. Managing the bench and the team, we have Nikki Cash, Paul Williams, Judge Knott, and Shocker Wave. Shockwave.
Shockwave, Shocker Wave.
Shocker.
Stop shuffling papers around now and get back to where does this team go? So the winner of this game will come back and play tonight at 8:30 p.m. against the winner of our next game, Montreal versus Jacksonville, which that's coming up at noon Pacific time. So Philly has played London before three times.
Yes. Victorious each time, the most recent being at ACDX 2019, and they won 175 over 128. So still a pretty close margin.
Right.
And London's ready to play.
London is ready. They're warmed up. They've had a chance to get used to the track here in the Showwear Center. We are sitting on an ice rink, so I don't know. It makes it nice and cool. I do like that. I have not been overly sweaty.
Oh, yeah. I'm definitely overly sweaty and not today, which is really good. So far. Whew. This game, though.
Yeah. It should be excellent. The teams are lining up. We're going to have number four jamming for London. That's Delta Strike against 152 Herman for Philly. They've got 15 seconds until Derby.
Very exciting.
I know. It's going to be good. I didn't look at the predictor to see what the computer algorithms and artificial intelligence has thought this game was going to be.
But you at home, you could check for us at stats.wftda.com, I believe.
Yeah.
So anyway, let us know on the Twitter. Follow us. Talk to us. Hashtag talk to WFTDA, the number two.
All right. We are underway finally in our third of the quarterfinals, first game of the day, and a quick back block penalty sending the London Jammer Delta Strike to the penalty box, and that gives Philly lead jam. Number 152, Herman, is your lead jammer.
Herman hitting the pack at turn number two, taking a little knee tap, but right back up.
And Herman rolling around, two skaters in front, have to let her go. And Herman pushes through, 4 points up.
Gingivitis going to the penalty box, sitting out for 30 seconds.
So a 4-on-3 pack advantage for London Brawling, as Herman now caught in the tripod at the front. As we have a bridge from number 9, Bethlord. And Bethlord, the pivot, reaches back, grabs the star. Bethlord doing a lot of, getting a lot of star passes in yesterday's game as well. And right off the bat, picks up the star and is now your jammer of record, as Herman is through with a second 4 points.
Looks like Herman's going to run a little long, letting Bethlord score a little bit halfway through the pack. Herman caught up in the back behind that London defense. Ooh, seeing that outside line. Ooh, and getting foiled, calling it. Putting 8 points, taking the first lead. That is Philly Roller Derby.
Yes. Ooh. Three more for Philly and three for London. So we end jam number one, 11-3. And we reset with number 501, Reptar, jamming for Philly Roller Derby. And number 16, Drac, with the star for London. Pack starting at the pivot line and now quickly rolling back. Interesting shift there.
4-3 pack advantage for Philly and lead jammer advantage as well. Two in a row for the skaters in black.
I like that start where Tramagotchi sort of snuck forward and then everyone came back. Like, no, you come up here. We're going to run back to the jammer line. Reptar through quickly with 4 points as Drac pushing at the front. The pivot for London, Katie Helvetica Black, was bumped out of bounds and held back. Reptar now forced out of bounds and also rolling backwards. Gaz with the run back.
And that's Hump Me going to the penalty box, setting out for 30 seconds.
Drac is finally clear, completes the initial. Reptar says, I will take another 4 points, and I will call off this jam.
Taking Philly Roller Derby to 19. London holding it 3. 27 minutes left in the first half.
Next up on our jammer line for London, Trisha Smackinawa. Jamming against number 15 from Philly. That is Persephone. One blocker in the penalty box as Humpy still sitting out the penalty. coming in late in the last jam and stepping forward. Oh, yes, declared lead jammer is Smack, but Smack forced out of bounds and has to roll back. Excellent extra bit of rolling back to the jammer line and now forced to fight through the tripod again.
Yep, doing a do-over.
It's like I get the honor of getting pointed at, but I still have to work hard again? And no points involved? Ugh.
Oh, and they're really making it work for this.
They are. And Frankenstein teaming up with Built to Spill on the engagement sides of the tripod. Now a quadrupod as they're getting an extra bonus push. Persephone also rolled back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Hummy doing some great defense teaming up at the back. Ooh, oh. She was lead jam already,
but finally out and able to score points a minute into the jam. So good work on the defense by Philly holding that up. Smack now on the points run as Persephone clears the pack. And Trisha Mackinawa calls off the jam. Two, I believe, was the... Oh, three. Let's get an extra finger out there. Three taking London to six. Philly held to 19.
Sable taking the star for the first time today for London.
And we've got Rousey at the line for Philly. Again, pack lining up at the pivot line. And now London starts the run back to the jammer line, but Philly keeping holding up front. Philly with three blockers on the track, London with four. London keeping one skater ahead, number 129, Just Jess, to do some offense, and Just Jess called for a penalty and sent to the box, and Rousey is your lead jammer.
But that is Sable hot on her wheels, about a quarter lap behind. The pack speeding towards turn number three.
And a forearm penalty called on Sable. So we will have a power jam for Philly and 4 points up for Rousey. As Rousey back engaged and ducking to the side, 3-on-3 in the pack. Although Philly now getting relief as their fourth blocker is out and London's fourth coming in and shortly as well. Rousey forced to the infield, has to recycle. And Rousey almost in, calls off the jam, diving to the floor.
So that was a 7-point jam, taking PRD to 26. London holding at 6 points, 23 and a half minutes, almost 24 minutes left in this first half.
And power start for Philly as number 020 Sable standing in the penalty box to start this jam number five. Pack lined well up to the front. Herman gets the run up.
So far we have four jammer rotation for each team. Herman through, lead jammer status going. They've gotten lead jam in all of these jams, but one, jam number three, did go to London.
This is some excellent early offense from Philly, knocking Sholin Scarlett out of bounds to kind of ease the way for Herman. Meanwhile, Humpy picking up a penalty and heads to the box. As Sable, out of the penalty box, star in hand, but forced out of bounds. Herman is through 4 points for Philly. That takes Philly to 30. London held at six, and Pivot is now off the table. As number nine, Bethlord, heads to the penalty box. Herman grabs the second four and calls off the jam. So an 8-0 run, Philly 34, London 6, 22 and a half minutes to go in the first period.
That's going to be Inky Minx taking the star for the first time for London. And I believe that is Reptar crouching low.
Yes,
I know that stance.
Like, I think I can see the 0-1. That pretty much must be it. Reptar forced out, but quickly rolling back as a forearm thins out the London pack further.
A lot of penalty trouble for London in these past two jams. So it's 4-2 pack advantage. Make it 4-3 pack advantage. That is V-Diva going to penalty box.
And Inky Minx finally clear, but Reptar through with 4 points. Yeah, looking at the penalty board, Humpney already sitting on three penalties, and we're only, what, six jams into the game.
We've got a racing micro pack, not really micro, maybe a three-quarter pack.
A moderate pack, I don't know.
Getting to our three more penalty trouble. We do have a power jam for PRD, Philly Roller Derby. So that will be Minx, Inky Minx, sitting out for up to 30 seconds for a back block penalty.
And Reptar taking full advantage with four more points, 12 total on the jam now, 46-6. Philly extending their lead out to 40 points. And a minute left in this jam. Should Reptar choose to run it even longer, Humpney throws the shoulder and gets the gets Reptar out of bounds. And Reptar says, that's fine. I will just lock your jammer in the box for another break between jams.
Yeah, Philly really on a run. They've held London to 6 points for four jams in a row. Mm-hmm. They're up to 50. That was a 16-point jam. So 50-6 in favor of Philly.
Now up on the jammer line is Persephone, number 15 for Philly. Inky Minx, starting off in the penalty box, is standing. Will be eligible for a lead jammer, and not a long wait either, as Inky Minx is released from the box, captured by Philly, and Persephone grabs lead jammer, fourth straight lead jammer status for Philadelphia.
Yeah, so every time that Philly has gotten lead jam, they've had, well, except for this time, they've gotten two scoring runs. So that time that was one scoring run, but still trucking, and London holding onto those 6 points. We have Philly with, is that our first 0-0
That
score?
Is our first 0-0
jam.
Sure
is.
Yes. Inky makes excellent work out of the backs. Got through quickly, forced the call off.
Second scoreless jam for Philly.
And Philly now changing it up, sending out Steph Leopard to jam.
For all you youngins, that's a play on an old Def Leppard. They're a British band,
their band
that I grew up loving. Def Leppard.
Yes, indeed. Timeout taken currently by London. I was like, where's London's jammer? Oh, they're all standing over here having a conversation. That makes sense.
So this timeout is brought to you by Rydell. The 2019 Wftda playoffs are... Are they talking? Oh, that was house. Sorry. Playoffs are brought to you by the popular Rydell Solaris. Solaris, the performance you demand, the comfort you've been missing.
All right, Philly with the strong early showing. 50-6, and as we mentioned, or as I mentioned earlier, a little bit of penalty trouble off the London side. Philly has three total penalties, while London has one skater with three total penalties and several others with one and two.
New jammer for London. That is Delta Strike in white for London.
Yes, Delta Strike jammed and started in the
jam number one.
And went to the penalty box. Now, however, pushing towards the front, Steph Leopard held up at the back. And Delta Strike forced out of bounds. And now being rolled back as Vanessa V. Diva sides at the very back of the pack. Says, I will hold you to the jammer line once again and allow Steph Leopard to break free. And grab lead jammer for Philly.
She only had to get around two London defenders, as there are two in the box.
Yes, and a good holdout of number 84, Katie Helvetica Black. The pivot for London was knocked out and being held onto by Tramagachi, who just was not, kept backing up a little bit, like not letting you come in. This time, Steph Leopard bumped out of bounds and rolls back as well, as Delta Strike still struggling at the front of the pack as they roll around turn two. Pack now completely split with Tramagachi serving as the bridge in between. Multiplayer block thins out the Philly pack, and finally Delta Strike is clear. Steph Leopard pushing. Here's the cry from the bench, calls off the jam. You know when I can hear the cry from the bench, the bench coach is being nice and loud.
Oh, yeah, they're on the far end. So that's 7-point jam for Philly, 57, London at 6, 18 and a half minutes left in the first half. Oh, look at the love on the screen right now. Hugs on the bench. It's all about love, love and skating.
That it is Herman back with the star for Philly. Philly one shy in the pack as Drac has the star for London Roller Derby. And Herman taken out of bounds and dropped onto by Madge. As both skaters in a tumble, and a lead jammer going to number 16, Drac for London, that was then immediately reabsorbed.
Yes, it was really pretty. They were sidestepping on the line, staying in bounds, getting lead jam. That is the second lead jam for London so far this game.
And stepping through, finally clearing the pack, is Drac. London's last points came the last time they had lead jammer. Herman clear the pack as well, as Drac swinging to the outside, forced out of bounds, rolled back, calls off the jam. Ginger Vitus with the run back. Jam referees checking in with the outside to figure out the count of hips. Oh, and no points awarded. I think it was a question of if they got past before being knocked out of bounds or not.
So that is our second scoreless jam of this game. And the third scoreless jam for Philly.
Number 42, Trisha Smackinawa jamming for London. 501, Reptar with the star for Philly. And Reptar hopping the inside corner and ducks in the around. Beautiful run. Elite jammer, Philly. Meanwhile, Trisha Smackinawa caught up at the front. Tripod held there. Once again, Tramagotchi serving as the bridge and now moving up to form an additional brace. Reptar is through with the first 4 points of the jam. Smack now star in hand. Looking on the outside, pivot for London is Katie Helvetica Black playing defense and trying to knock Reptar out. Unable to do so. 4 more points on the board as Philly sheds a blocker. That is Jail Bars heading to the penalty box.
Reptar just shrugging off all these hits, getting through, squeezing through those between those shoulders for four more points, 12 points so far, taking Philly to 69.
And Trisha Smackinawa dancing on the outside, Tramagotchi at front, and Smack goes right through to finally clear the pack. Reptar sitting on 12 points and still in, and sneaks around the inside. Good work getting the pack to shift to the outside, opens up the inside lane. 16-0 run. Now Philly 73, London 6.
So, yes, that's Reptar's second 16-point jam. So, in three jams, she has scored 24 points, right? 16-32 plus 8.
Ooh, 40 all right,
points.
40
in
points.
Three jams. Sorry.
So,
that
yes, that would be, that's that's well over many of the. That's over half of the points total, if that's true.
It is true. 40.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, official timeout coming to a close. Number 020, Sable with the star for London. And that is number 15, Persephone jamming for Philly. Packed midway between jammer and pivot line. As Philly gets some assistance out of the penalty box. Now London one blocker shy. As Just Jess sitting in the box.
The lateral movement of Philly's defense is amazing. Like, every time you think Sable's going to get out, they shut down that outside lane, inside lane. They're there.
Yeah, they are doing, and maybe that was the superpower acquired. In the, although, because I haven't seen Philly play this season because I didn't go to ACDX and couldn't tune in. I'm assuming that's probably just training and excellent ability and work. The hard work rather than being struck by lightning on an airplane. 4 points up for Persephone as Sable once again almost out and then just knocked out of bounds and forced to roll back. Persephone through for 4 more, 8 total.
I watched
on the jam and a cut track called on Sable.
Oh, that's the fourth power jam for Philly Roller Derby. Persephone continuing on a third scoring pass.
And almost out, but managing to stay in. Now held up at the front by Beth Lord. Teaming up with 1236 Madge, but Persephone through 12 on the jam. Taking Philly to 85. We've got 30 seconds of jam time left. 13:40 on the clock for the period. And each team now with one blocker in the penalty box as Sable is released. Persephone forced out of bounds, rolls back to the jammer line. Sable finally completes the initial pass. Persephone forced out again and calls off the jam with 5 seconds to go.
It's big. Another 16-point jam for Philly.
Mm-hmm.
4-2 pack advantage for Philly as well. And we have Delta Strike back on the jam line for London.
And that is 8 straight scoreless jams for London. Nothing since jam 3 when they picked up their second 3 points. 9-0-2 Rousey with the star for Philly. As Delta Strike forced out of bounds and Vidiva rolling her back.
Going to Rousey.
London only 2 blockers on the track. They were doing some offense, now breaking back to play defense against Rousey, but nothing doing. As Rousey breaking through for 4 points. And Philly, excellent work breaking up that pair. That's number 66, Little Loca, splitting them up. Finally, London packed back to full strength as they try to regroup and regrip. Kristen Lee now manning the kickstand position and able to shut Rousey down. However, Delta Strike also pushing at the back end. Multiplayer block, or believe, called on Beth Lord. And Rousey.
That was a hard fought. Yeah, third pass. That took some work, but she is through, coming around again.
Mm-hmm. The unearned pass, so 3 points on that last run. 11 total takes Philly to an even 100. And with this run through, Rousey will pick up 4 more, taking London to 104. As Delta Strike just not gaining any ground. Star is in hand, pushing through. Pivot just released from the box is Beth Lord. And Delta Strike forced out of bounds, has to roll all the way back behind Russian Bayou.
And a slight Rousey face plant at the front.
Yes, Rousey bumped to the ground and the jam will be called. Medical staff will come out to check. And we will take an official timeout with the score 104-6. London is not here to mess around. Philly is not here. London is also not here to mess around, but they're having no luck getting past Philly because Philly's defense is just so on point today.
Oh, yeah.
Here in the replay, we can see as Rousey forces through around the outside, breaking free, and immediately London, or Philly, just regrouping, roll back. Let's go get back to our to the jammer and hold them steady.
Yeah, this is a big difference from the last time they played. It was only like just under 50 points, the spread of points from that loss, 175 to 128 at ECDX. So, I mean, but still, we're still early in the game.
That we are.
Yep, just under 11 minutes left in the first half.
Medical staff continuing to check on Rousey. And the London skaters had come out onto the track, now rolling back to their bench. Once again, winner of this moves into our semifinal game tonight at 8:30 p.m. Pacific time. Please adjust accordingly. They will face the winner of Montreal versus Jacksonville. That game will be played next right here on WFTDA.TV. Jacksonville with a win yesterday over Ann Arbor to advance to the quarterfinal round.
And let's look at the penalties. Yes, we've noticed a lot of London skaters going to the box. Jess has 4. She's sitting on 4. Sholin also sitting on 4. There's a couple skaters with 3. Humpney has 3. Beth Lord has 3.
Humpney has cleaned it up in the last few games because I think she had 3 in like jam number 6. And we're all the way to jam 12. So slightly cleaner at that point. On the Philly side, nobody with more than 1. I know we did. We sort of skipped over that, but they have been playing a very clean game and a very tight defensive game. Just the lockdown and the ability to knock out and recycle and string the recycling back as far as they can and then still regroup. Very very well executed defense from the Philly side. Ah, we haven't had a score adjustment. Looks like we were up to 18 points for that last jam. So now Philly 107. And London still held at 6. As we have got Reptar up. We're doing a little track cleanup.
Strousey.
Oh, Strousey, excuse me. Thank you.
London is looking for an official review.
Ah, yes, I do see the blink. The referees are discussing. When we come out, we will have number 42, Trisha Smakinawa, with the star preparing for London, however. We first have to do the track repair / track cleanup.
Well, during this official review, I want to give you a word from our sponsors. Let me tell you about Adam Skates. Have you tried the Adam Savant wheels? See what you've been missing at adamskates.com. And next up, it looks like it's going to be Smack. Smack is one of the two lead jams that have happened so far for London. Mm-hmm. Was done by Smack. Smack, yes. Coming out.
The other coming from Drac. London has, as you mentioned, just the two. They're lead scoring on points. Well, they do only have they've had the two scoring passes. So Smack with three, and also Bethlord as the pivot, with the one time that Bethlord has received the star, picked up the first 3 points of the game for London. Yesterday, Bethlord getting a lot of star passes. I was on the game with Queen City, and they used it significantly. Has been much less star passing from London today. I'm thinking that perhaps the Philly defense being better at may have seen some of that stat yesterday, and then we'll just keep them apart.
Well, there you go. A little punching to the arm there on Smack. Is that to get you through? Help me. Can you give me a little shot in the arm there too?
Warm me up. Warm up the arms.
Yeah. But yeah, it turns out there's no official review.
All right. That's good. Yes, the light did go off, so I think we are in official timeout. As the track repair continues.
This official timeout is going to be also brought to you by Antic Skates.
All right.
Yes, the all-new Antic Jet Carbon is packed with features at a great price. Antic Jet Carbon, featherweight performance.
All right, now we get to see our jammer stats. Looking at the Philly side of the board. Philly has three jammers with 100% lead percentage. Steph Leopard, Reptar, and Rousey. Currently, Reptar leading all scorers with 40 points. You caught that earlier. Herman with 19, Persephone with 16, and Rousey and Steph Leopard each with 7. And I'm not going to do the math. I will trust that the scoreboard is right, and that adds up to 107 points, which is an impressive run.
Oh, definitely.
So we have a Philly jammer sitting in the penalty box. Now, because of the injury, that penalty being sat by Herman. So we have number 42, excuse me, Trisha Smakinawa. I was stuck on Smack. I'm like, no, what's the full name? Smakinawa is jamming for London and pushing towards the front on the power start. London with Bethlord and 1239 Madge up at the front, causing some mayhem and trying to break things free. Now rolling back to meet Herman as Herman is released from the penalty box. So the 32nd power jam, power kill, successful. And Herman out of the box, lead jammer Philly.
Yep, Trish Smakinawa Ooh, we have a star pass for London. The new gemmer of record is Beth Lord.
Yes, Beth Lord.
Accepting the star owner for the second time.
Yeah.
Sorry.
No, that's quite all right. Second time and picking up points for London.
She's the owner of what? What is she?
She's now the owner of 6-7 points total for London. She scored the first points of the game for London and has scored the most recent points as well. So a 4-4 tie jam. Our first tie jam that wasn't 0-0. And we sit. Oh, I'm sorry. I missed the 3 points. That's not a tie. Never mind. Chicken, pay attention to the scoreboard and the jam refs that are holding up fingers.
So Smack taking London to double digits.
114-10. And new jammer on the London side, Jack Attack with the star. Jam against 501 Reptar. But first, an official timeout. Oh, that was very short. Too short to read. To read a sponsor. Whistle blows and we are underway. Jack Attack looking to the inside. Reptar starting on the out and then forced to the in.
Jack Attack. Woo!
Almost. Good work holding the foot up but pushing at the front. Reptar held up at the back by the full four pack of London.
The pack spreading between turns one and two.
And Philly losing a blocker to the penalty box. So they will have two at the front. One of those two, Vanessa V. Divasites, who finally has to let Jack Attack go. And Jack Attack lead jammer London. This is London's third lead of the game. As Reptar pushing at the back, bounces out. Now looks to the outside. Oh, and just knocked out of bounds. Rolled back by 129, just Jess. As Jack Attack breaks through and calls off the jam. Reptar still, I believe, on the initial pass, but just Jess listening to the bench calls off the jam. 4 points up. Takes us to a 100-point game, 114-14.
And that is only the fourth scoreless jam for Philly.
London will pass the star off to Inky Minx and Persephone out to jam for Philly. And another official review, or official timeout, rather, called.
This official timeout is brought to you by S1 Helmets. Durable, functional, stable. The S1 Pro Knee Pads are built for roller derby. Find them at s1helmets.com. S1helmets.com.
A little bit of track repair being done on the far side of the track. Got to make sure the tape is all rolled up. And we also have a jammer in the penalty box. Let's see.
4-2 pack advantage. So all kinds of advantages for Inky Minx in this jam. Look at, including lead jammer advantage, power jam, and 4-2 pack advantage.
All right, London looking to pick up some points on that as a illegal contact penalty called on Reptar in that last jam and landed her in the box. And a nice little hop by Inky Minx to grab 4 points. Now London has to this point not had a multi-pass jam. Inky Minx now engaged on that second pass as Reptar is released. London defense ready to accept the jammer in, leaving Inky Minx to push at the front.
Wow,
against the Philly wall.
Oh, she did reset, but Reptar's moves.
No.
Stay line. Oh, track cut penalty.
That's the track. Oh, Reptar thought that was clean.
That is the first power jam for London. London going with a little momentum, two lead jams in a row.
Mm-hmm.
Points scored in the current three latest jams they have scored.
Yes, and Beth Lord providing some offense. Inky Minx pushing forward. Forearm called on V Diva.
Her second one this jam. Second penalty this jam. Inky Minx resetting.
Inky Minx will roll back. London stopping that run back a little bit short. And now Inky Minx again pushing forward as London waiting for the return of Reptar. Reptar now back and fully engaged between Sholin, Scarlet, and Madge. has humped me with the brace on the tripod and the run back. Now Bethlord rolling forward to provide some offense, but now breaking back to bridge as Inky Minx just trapped. Philly defense again, surprisingly not willing to let the jammer go by.
That's two scoreless jams in a row for Philly, holding them at 114. And we have double twos for London. 8-point jam by Inky Minx. And we have just over 5.5 minutes left in this first period.
And now we do have an official review, I believe. I think this is London calling for a review. And we will, after our head referee reads up on it, our head referee Nitsugi will announce everything. Speaking of officials, our skating officials, Nitsugi, as I mentioned, Jesse Jackass, Lord Lex Dalt, Jean-Philippe Amon, Admiral Mayhem, PK Biddy, Robin U Blind, and Rockstar.
London is requesting an insubordination penalty on the jammer from the last jam.
All right.
That last jam was the first multi-pass jam for London, but again, they are on a roll. Let's see what they can do with this momentum.
Continuing down our officials list with the non-skating officials, Trauma Doll, Tenacious D-Cup, Dolan It Out, Nine Inch Wheels, Mask Her Raid, Torque Mama, Amy Farrell Fowler, Cairo Fracture, D. Molly Shure, Read the Rules, Tumble Tina, and Locomotive. Thanks to all our officials, whether striped or non-striped, in their shirt of choice.
Oh, definitely.
I am loving the leopard print there.
Well, it is Catter Day. I have the leopard on as well.
I know.
But I am loving the London bench coach with a sequins.
That is also an excellent look.
Yesterday, she had on a silver sequins, and today, the beautiful sequins dress is just gorgeous. But I want to take a moment to tell you about Derby Without Borders. There's donation booths here at the playoffs, and they will be at Champs. So bring your gently used gear and find out how you can help at derbywithoutborders.org.
Winner of this game moves into our semifinal and continues their quest for the Hydra. Semifinal will be at 8:30 p.m. tonight against the winner of Montreal versus Jacksonville. Remember, top three teams from this tournament move on to championships in Montreal coming up in November. If you haven't got your tickets yet, I guess start making travel arrangements. All right, let's hear the result.
Upon review, the no call will stand.
Succinct, to the point. I like that in a head referee. All right, reset for jam number 16. We've got number 42, Trisha Smackinawa jamming for London, and Steph Leopard, number 29, jamming for Philly. Steph Leopard forced to the outside. Trisha Smackinawa just pushing at the tripod in the middle. And Sholin Scarlett heads to the penalty box. Now two blockers on the track for London.
Yep, Sholin paying for that huge hit at the back of the pack, but it didn't really stop Steph from getting lead jammer status for Philly.
Yes. Steph is through and going up the inside. Oh, almost. Thought the lane was there. Lane closed by Smack. And Trisha Smackinawa rolling back. Oh, and an illegal contact called on Steph Leopard. So power jam and a full 2-minute jam for Trisha Smackinawa and London Roller Derby.
Yep, Steph will lose her lead jammer status. And that is two power jams in a row for London.
And a quick star pass off through the middle. Bethlord now with the star for London. Excellent work by Trisha Smackinawa. Behind the pack, like, not going to get lead anyway. Might as well pass it over and get out and get scoring immediately.
Yeah, Bethlord really proving to be a great relief jammer. This is the third time she's accepted the star so far this game.
And Tats dances, and keeps the feet inbounds for 4 points. Wftda heading back to the penalty box. That is her fourth penalty, possibly fifth. We'll see if they update the table, but it says four right now, so I'm going with that.
Yeah, I'm guessing it's five. I think it's five, but anyway.
In any case, Bethlord is out, has 4 points, and is on the second scoring pass already and pushing the pack forward. Tamagotchi holding the back, or holding is the brace, now rotating around the other side.
That's Jail Bars as well, teaming up with her. Yes. Ooh, one more, she's through. Beth Lord had to work for that, but four more points for London. And as we have the third scoreless jam in a row, fourth scoreless jam in a row, third for PRD.
And the second two-pass jam in a row for London with an eight takes them to 30 total. Yep.
And just kidding, there was 3 points awarded to Steph on that, taking them to 117.
All right, number 152, Herman with the star for Philly, and number 0, Jack Attack, back out to jam for London. Jack Attack jammed a couple of jams ago. Got lead jammer. This time, Jack Attack trying on the inside. Nothing doing. Now a lane opens up and sneaks through. Lead jammer London. Herman, however, hot on her quads, maybe 40 feet behind and giving chase as the pack regroups. Penalty box currently empty.
Yeah, Jack Attack is at 100% lead jammer status, 2 for 2.
Jack looking inside, outside, dodging, dipping, ducking. And now trapped.
And really smart, just probably pushing. How much? She's like, is that 20 feet? Is that 20 feet? Looking back, no,
now?
No.
Still not 20 feet.
Nope.
Built the spill, teaming up with Gingivitis at the front. Finally, they have to let her go. And she is through. Jack Attack with 4 points. Herman now looking to the inside, forced out of bounds along with Humpney, and has to roll back. Jack Attack slices through quickly for 4 points. Herman back up again, stumbling.
Look at that catch in the match. Front. Oh, catch and a miss. Okay, so Herman worked for that initial pass. 43 seconds left on the jam clock.
The 4 points up for Herman. Jack Attack with 12 now after that third four-point run.
Jack being told, trust your blockers, keep on running.
Yes. London choosing to run long. They're down enough. They've got the point differential. Choosing to continue the run. Herman held up. As 00 Meryl Stripper coming in to try and provide some offense, but Herman knocked out of bounds. Now Meryl Stripper with the run back of Jack Attack.
This is the highest scoring jam so far for London. With 12 points and counting, Jack is halfway through.
And jam comes to a close. 4 more up for London, 16 total, 3 more coming in for Philly. A 16-7 run, 124-46. And we are down to under a minute of game time in this half.
Yes, and London really on a run. Thank you to my lovely producer, this is Rich Mahogany. So the past 5 jams, they've scored. London, after 9 scoreless jams, really on a run. Drack back on the jam line for London.
Yes, Drack with star London. Persephone jamming for Philly. Drack pushing towards the front. 2 skaters to beat. Jail Bars holding the line, but Drack is through. A lead jammer as Philly loses number 99, Russian Bayou, to the penalty box. Philly starting to not catch up on the penalty counts. But they do seem to be having a few more key penalties right in the last few jams as 4 points are up for Drack. Persephone held at the front, dances the line, checks the toes. Yes, I kept them in bounds and works through. No, did not keep them in bounds. Wow, all right.
Wow.
So I can't see it. It's on the other side of the track. I'm like, oh, she looks like it's fine. Oops.
3 power jams of the last 4 going to London, and 4 out of the last 5 lead jams also going to London.
All right, Drack in second scoring pass, pushing ahead as Bethlord providing some offense.
Period clock has expired. Less than 1 minute left on the jam clock. We've also had 4 two-minute jams in a row. Yay for endurance.
Yes, indeed. Drack has 4 more points. Now looking to the outside. Whoa.
I kick it to stay in bounds.
Yes. Got to keep that weight balance correctly.
Look at that. Yeah. Patience and strength just getting through. 1 more blocker to pass.
Side to side. Lateral from both skaters, and track is clear for more. 12 on the jam, is 10 seconds to go on the jam clock. Star pass by Philly to number 21, Tramagotchi.
That is their first star pass of the game.
It is theirs, and we have one more point up for London. Takes us to 55.
124 for Philly. You have about 14 and a half minutes to go refresh your beverage, relieve yourselves. Get on Twitter and talk to us. We'll be checking your messages.
Yes,
shortly.
Indeed. Use that hashtag talk to WFTA, or the number two, that would be talk number two, WFTDA. We'll be back with the second half of Philly versus London in 14 and a half minutes. You are watching the 2019 WFTDA International Playoffs from Seattle, Washington on WFTDA.tv. Scott Chicken.
Muffin Tumble.
We'll be back in 15. Welcome back to the second half of Philly Roller Derby versus London Roller Derby at the 2019 WFTDA International Playoffs. That's what we're doing. I'm Scott Chicken.
And I'm Up and Tumble.
Yes, you are. And we're just trying to come to grips with what we just saw in that last half. Philly, huge lead in the beginning. And then all of a sudden in the last six jams, London, I don't know, woke up, decided it was time to play. Something happened. London scored 49 points in the last six jams.
Wow, they
going
really
from six
forever
to 55.
They had 6 points forever, and they really did make a run.
They did. It was a solid run. Looking at the scoring, because I know this came up on Twitter, Beth Lord has received the star, I think, three times and has 15 total points. Jack Attack leading scorers for London with 20. Jack Attack also the only London jammer with a perfect lead jam percentage at 100. On the Philly side, you've got two jammers with a 100% lead jam percentage, Steph Leopard and Rousey. Reptar is leading all scorers with 40 points. So Philly, huge lead, then a little bit of letting off on the gas, I don't know. But London picking it up and coming back in that late part of the second half. Looking at the penalty board, we have got a total of 26 for London, a total of 19 for Philly. London has four penalties for Just Jess and Beth Lord, while Philly, Russian Bayou with four. So no one in imminent danger. We don't have any five and six, but still, four is dangerous.
Yeah, V-Diva also has four.
Oh, I missed the V-Diva line.
Yeah.
You're right.
How can you miss V-Diva?
I can't.
You know, I am so excited for the second half. Like, I think they're both going to come out fighting like crazy. I left the dais for a moment. I walked by the locker room for PRD, and I could hear a portion of their pep talk, and it got me very excited. I had the goosebumps. Yes, and I have a soft spot. I love both these teams, of course, but I've known some of those skaters from PRDs for many, many years, admired them, watched them, and gotten to know a couple of them, and it's really just fun to see them still be in this game.
All right, so we start off the half. Penalty box empty. All skaters eligible are on the track. Herman jamming for Philly. Drack for London. Drack going left and right. And just as soon as I said nobody's in the penalty box, we send Sholin Scarlett to the box for a forearm penalty. And that will free Herman. Lead jammer, Philly. Philly leading 124 to 55. Winner moves on to the semifinal this evening at 8:30 Pacific against the winner of Montreal versus Jacksonville. The loser moves to our consolation bracket, where they will play tomorrow morning at 11 a.m. Pacific time.
Star pass? Mm-hmm. Is that our Beth Lord?
That is.
And power jam for Philly.
So Beth Lord moving to the penalty box as the jammer. Philly also shedding a blocker to the penalty box. That is the fifth penalty for Beth Lord. 4 points up for Herman. As Herman rounds the pack and rounds the track and heads towards the pack, four blockers on the track for London. And the jam is called off. 2 points up for Philly. Total of six takes them to 130.
That means we'll have a power start. Drack sitting out the last few seconds of the penalty from the previous jam.
That's Beth Lord. Was
oh,
Drack,
that's right. It's Beth Lord. Thank you. Good catch.
It's all right. Beth Lord removing the pivot stripe from under the jammer cap and tossing it over.
The Reptar jamming for Philly. It's a pack quickly reaching turn number two. and coming to a screeching halt. Power jam over, and we do have, we would have had an empty penalty box.
Almost for just 2 seconds before Just reported. Just rolling in just as Anne Frankenstein rolled out, and Reptar is through and lead Jammer. Reptar now in on the scoring run as Bethlord, star in hand, pushing through, but no move to pass it off to Madge, the pivot for London. Madge gets bumped out. Reptar going out as well, but Reptar laying on the inside through for 4 points. 134 Philly. Now as London held at 55. Bethlord dodging, dancing, and does break clear. Russian Bayou trying to slow things down, but not quite able to. And Reptar calls off the jam. 2 more points for Philly. A second 6-point jam, 136 to 55.
So it's Philly's turn to go on a run. Two leads in a row and 0 points for London in this half so far. But 12 more points for PRD, taking them to 136. London holding at 55. 27 minutes, just under 27 minutes left in this game.
Jack attack with the star for London and Persephone jamming. For Philly, London with one blocker in the penalty box. And Jack attack looking sideways now, forcing to the inside, now to the out as Persephone trying to get around that, trying to get around both the Philly pack and then getting caught by London and now heading to the penalty box for a high block. So power jam, first power jam of the period for London.
And the fourth all game.
And Jack attack ducks back in. Lead jammer still open. A forearm penalty being called on a London blocker. That was number 84, Katie Helvetica Black. That is her third on the game. London now with 2 skaters at 5 penalties. As Jack attack still pushing, Persephone now out of the penalty box.
Yeah.
And re-engaged, so penalty kill again, very successful for Philly. They did this a couple of times in the first half where we don't care if our jammer's not on the track. You're just not going anywhere. Persephone finally clear, not lead jammer because of the penalty, but is now on a scoring run. We got 41 seconds of jam time left.
And lead jammer still up for grabs, but no, the helmet cover was stashed, so no lead. Mm-hmm. This jam will continue just for 33 more seconds. That is our first no lead jam of this game.
I believe so, yes. Jack attack in on the scoring pass as Persephone ducking under and trying to work through, caught up in a pile at the outside of turn two, and both jammers now rolling back towards the jammer line. In fact, many skaters rolling backwards, both on and off the track. Gaz picking up a penalty, thinning London's pack down to 3, and the time will run out on the jam. 3 points up for London, 4 for Philly.
That takes Philly to 140 and London to 58.
So we're looking at 2 skaters for London, as I mentioned, with 5 penalties. Bethlord and number 129, Just Jess, both sitting on 5. Number 42, Trisha Smackinawa jamming for London. And number 29, Steph Leopard with the star for Philly. As the pack rolls into the outside of turn 2. Yes, holding on to the outside. Steph Leopard, beautiful run.
Look at her. Oh, she just jumped into speed mode right at the turn.
Right. Just like sudden acceleration. Impacts the pack, gets bumped out of bounds, but now back on it again, forced out of bounds. Humpney with the rollback.
Yeah, that was a great defense by London at the back of the pack. And smack through on initial.
Yeah, smack finally getting past Jailbars. Jailbars with the excellent last line of defense.
Huge hit.
And the cry of call from the Philly bench, very loud, as we mentioned in the first half when they were at the other end. Now it's even louder because they're closer to us. But, Steph Leopard, here's the cry, calls off the jam, 4 points up for Philly.
and Sholin with huge hits in that jam, just really, really doing great defense in that last jam. 144-58 in favor of Philly, 23 minutes left in this game.
152 Herman with the star for Philly. London sending out Delta Strike to jam. Delta Strike trying on the middle, trying on the inside. Herman forced to the out of bounds on the inside edge. But now at the front, Pumpney holding and has to let her go. But no, the unearned pass, not lead jammer for Herman. That will give lead jammer to Delta Strike.
Yep, that is the first lead jam. No, the second lead jam for London. Nope, the first lead jam for London. This half. Sorry, my writing is awful. Okay, I'm crossing that out.
It's all right. And the pack racing ahead as London's bench coach saying, you just continue cycling this. We're going to run this one a little longer. Herman is already engaged in the pack on the scoring pass.
And getting taken back to just before turn number one.
And they pile up on the outside as Sholin Scarlett, I think, taken to the ground. And is now rolling back on the outfield as Herman also recycled back. Both jammers tied up at that top of turn two. Humpy now on the run back with Herman. Is at the front of the pack, Delta Strike tied up, getting a little offensive assistance from Just Jess, and finally breaks through with four. Herman once again shouldered out of bounds, and Sholin Scarlett picking up a forearm penalty. That is her fifth, and all forearms. So she's got the full set of five forearms. I was trying to think of the poker
five
term.
Five of a kind.
Yes, five of a kind. I mean, that's the
not
word
a term,
I'm
but that's not a term.
But it should be.
If they're wild, and guess what? 8008 is a wild card.
All right, Delta Strike rolled back to the top of the turn, now engaged and pushing forward and bumped out of bounds again and rolled back by Built to Spill as we run out of time on the jam. 4 points for Philly. Two more for London. 148-64.
That was a high scoring jam for London in the second half of 6 points. So, and a lot of single digit jams so far the second half. So a whole lot of defense going on. 20 minutes left in this game.
Rousey out to jam for the first time this half for Philly. Drack with the star for London, and Rousey is your lead jammer. But Drack right behind. This is, I think, the fastest that both jammers have gotten out in quite some time.
Oh, yeah,
they
just
are racing around the
10 seconds and the jam. That was a quick jam.
Mm-hmm.
18-second jam.
3 points up for Philly as Rousey snakes off those back three skaters and rolls up. So we sit 151-64.
And Jack Attack is back.
Jack Attack jamming against number 15, Persephone. As Philly and London starting half the pack towards the front line and then rolling back to the jammer line. Jack Attack forced out of bounds. Teflon Donna holding that line, and Persephone sneaks through for lead jammer. Persephone sizing up the next approach. Slowly swooping through, and a star pass to number 9, Bethlord for London. Bethlord is through, and on the scoring pass, Persephone forced out of bounds. Rolled back, Bethlord now engaged with the pack. Swinging left to right as Persephone also left to right. And a nice little hop and a second foot down. Like, yes, I'm in bounds. Thank you very much. We're going to continue and take my points.
Yeah, that was a beautiful escape. Escape and hop and spin and out of there.
Yes, Bethlord also pushing through for four. So that will take Bethlord to 19 total on the game. And jam called off after three more for Philly.
That takes him to 158. London with 68 points. They scored 4 points on that jam.
90. I was going to say 90 point spread with 18 and a half minutes to go.
Oh, I love the easy math scores.
I know.
Sure.
That's probably the last time I'll be able to do that.
Oh, look at that replay. Great. Yes. That was Teflon Donna doing what she does. Mm-hmm.
Like, I own this line. You think you own this line, but it is mine.
You shall not pass.
Hell not. Reptar jamming against Trisha Smackinawa. And Reptar. Oh, back block called. Reptar will head to the penalty box. So power jam for Trisha Smackinawa. Lead jammer still open and granted.
That is the fifth power jam all game and the second this half for London.
Three blockers on the track for both teams. Although Philly getting Russian Bayou back as Trisha Smackinawa eased out of bounds. And by eased, I mean violently ejected from the track. Rolled backing all the way out of play. Called, sends jail bars to the penalty box as Reptar is now out. Power jam complete, and London will await the return of Reptar.
Ooh, and let there be light.
And it got brighter. Wow, all right. Oh, and now it's getting dimmer again. I don't know how much of this lighting is showing up on the video, but wow, it just got way brighter for a second. Trisha Smackinawa is using that light to her advantage. Slides around the outside of the pack for four more points. Eight total on the jam for London as Reptar in the middle of the pack, but being held up well. Forced out number 84, Katie Helvetica Black, but Black rolls out as well, so no significant running backwards. As Philly again on lockdown mode, holding smack at the front of the pack.
Look at that.
And Trisha Smackinawa finally through. 4 points, largest jam of the half for London with 12. And another penalty thinning out the Philadelphia defense.
Ooh, and another pass. Great jam by Smack.
Yeah, 16 total.
That matches our highest scoring jam from the first half, 16 points for Smack, taking London to 84 points. Scoreless jam for Philly, they are at 158 points. And this is their first scoreless jam of this half, and this is their third all game.
Yeah, Philly's been doing a great job of locking down the opposing jammers, but also breaking their own jammers free. So not surprised that there have only been three scoreless for them. Inky Minx with the star for London. Herman jamming for Philly. And Herman pushing at the back as Bethlord serving as a bridge, now moving forward to provide some offensive assistance. But Philly absorbing the bump and continuing on. As Anne Frankenstein teaming up with Teflon Donna at the front of the pack. Oh, Inky Minx shoulders Anne Frankenstein to the ground, gets around Teflon Donna. Lead jammer, second straight lead jam of the for London and third in the period. Harmon now star in hand is rolled back, and Inky Minx is through quickly for 4 points. Star pass for Philly. This is what, their second of the game, I believe? They had one at the last jam of the first half.
It is their second. It's a new jammer record, Meryl Stripper.
All right. Meryl Stripper clears the pack on the scoring run now, puts the star on the helmet as Inky Minx still rolled into the pack, choosing to let the jam run. London bench is saying, we need to get more points. Let's go. And Philly is saying, you don't need any more points. You're not going to go. We're just going to stop you right now. Please meet Anne Frankenstein, our kickstand. You will not get by. As Meryl Stripper bumped out and rolled back and will also deal with a tripod, in that case anchored by Hump Me. And Teflon Donna just I'm just going to stand here and bridge. I don't know. We'll see. I'll say some encouraging words, maybe roll forward. Having never skated, I'm like, how exciting is the being the bridge? Like, you're like, I can't do anything but stand here. It's a super important job. It's a super important job, but like, I want to help, but I can't because I'm here. 3 points each on that pass.
Make that 7 points for London. So London winning that jam by 7-3 over Philly. 161 for Philly, 91 for London.
We are down to 13:20 to go in the game. And what are we now? That's 70 points. I can do that math because it's the same same end digit. I don't have to deal with individual numbers. Ooh, big hit coming from number 66, Little Loca on Drac, jamming for London. But Drac now up at the front and pushing Steph Leopard, number 29, at the back. But Drac is your lead jammer.
For the third lead jam in a row for London. But that point spread has not changed. It's actually gone up 2 points. It was 69-point difference at the half, and now it's at the beginning of this jam, it was a 69% difference. Oh, I'm sorry, 71. So they've just moved up. Everybody scored more
points.
Everybody's
rolling, yep. But we're keeping the same, similar distance between the two. Drac pushing at the front. Steph Leopard still held at the back as on the initial pass. And really, Philly has time on their side. So if they can just hold on to this, you know, burn a two-minute jam, give up 4 points, okay. You can do that and still have time. London forcing out Steph Leopard and rolling back. And again, now we have two bridges as the packs are separating out almost as far as possible. And Drac is finally clear for four. Philly rolls back to provide some assistance on the offense. And a star pass to Tramagotchi, number 21 now with star second star pass of the half for Philly.
Tramagotchi accepted the star once in the first half. So three star passes all game. The score now 161 to 96. That was a 5-point jam for London.
So London knocking on 100. We're at 11 and a half minutes to go in the game. Winner moving on to play tonight at 8:30 against Philly, the winner of Montreal versus Jacksonville. Loser will move on to play Arizona in our 11 a.m. game tomorrow morning.
Jack Attack back on the jam line for London. It is Persephone jamming for Philly.
And Jack Attack almost clear, but then caught up and pushed out as the pack also caught up. Jack Attack steps, bumped. Beautiful shoulder for Man Frankenstein. And a slight rollback for Jack Attack. Jack Attack now looking, finds room on the inside and grabs lead jammer. That takes Jack Attack over the 50% point on lead on jam leads, or maybe back to 50%.
And four lead jams in a row for London.
Jack Attack bumped down and out of bounds as off to the penalty box again for the sixth forearm for Sholin Scarlett. Also sitting on six is Beth Lord for London. Philly has Russian Bayou now with five penalties as Persephone is cleared of the pack. Jack Attack rolling back on the outside to come back in behind Ginger Vitus and the Philly pack has 4 points up for Persephone. No points yet granted to Jack Attack from London, and Jack Attack calls off the jam. And a three-point run for London. So Philly coming out with the jam steal.
Yep, that takes the score 165 for Philly, 99 for London. 9 minutes and 40 seconds left in this game.
Back setting with Trisha Smackinawa jamming for London. Rousey with star for Philly. We've got three on three in the pack. As Anne Frankenstein sits in the penalty box, Sholin Scarlett standing and standing on six. And out of the pack and lead jammer is Rousey, breaking that four jam string for London.
Rousey is 2 for 2 lead jammers in the second half. And we have Smack out of the pack.
And Rousey out of the pack too. Oh, but a cut track called by the outside pack ref. Power jam London. Trisha Smackinawa on the scoring pass. As Anne Frankenstein released from the penalty box. Three blockers on the track right now for Philly as London will try and break things free, but not able to stop it before Anne Frankenstein is back and Philly regroups into a tripod with an outrider as Little Loca caught up at the back and now moving forward. Smack forced out of bounds, saw the farther run back, cuts back out of bounds, and rolls back again with everybody else.
Rossi has completed her penalty. The power gem is over. She's going to hit the pack at turn number three.
And Frankenstein picking up a direction and heads back to the penalty box. And now we're back into shutdown mode by the Philly defense. And finally, Trisha Smaganawa is out with 4 points. 30 seconds to go in the jam, roughly, and the first points going up on the board.
Yep, London has broken the century mark, 103 and counting.
Multiplayer block thins out the London pack, sending number 7, Kristen Lee, to the penalty box. And Rousey is clear with 4 points, tying up the jam. Trisha Smaganawa tries to swing around the outside, gets taken down. Tramagotchi going down as well. No penalty called, and Smack will roll back as Rousey sneaks up on the inside, collects 4 more points. 2 points up for Trisha Smaganawa, an 8-6 jam. So again, another case of Philly sneaking out and grabbing the lead.
Okay, 8-6 jam. So we had our first foul out of the game that we were aware of. Sholin.
She did pick up a direct.
So that was 7.
Oh, man.
7 4 arm penalties, that we believe.
But she broke the string. It was not all 4 arm penalties. Oh, okay. The 7th was a direction.
Okay.
Just to vary it up at the last at the last moment. We do have an official review now from London. And we will cover that penalty board right now. So as you can see, we've got Sholin Scarlett fouling out for London. Beth Lord sitting with 6. Just Jess has 5. Those are the troubled skaters for the London side. And over on Philly, you've got Russian Bayou with 5. And Frankenstein both sitting on 4.
Oh, and I don't know if you mentioned this earlier, but during the first half, one of our officials went down. So Jesse Jackass hurt his head. He did get checked out. He is fine, but
London,
we appreciate...
London is requesting an insubordination penalty on the Philly jammer from the last jam.
Okay, sorry about that, but he did get his noggin checked out. We do care about everyone's brains, so he is okay. Let me also tell you, we have just under 7 minutes left in this game, so in 7 minutes you have time to get a snack. We may do so, and we may get the treat of something from Togo's.
Ooh.
Togo's, they have fresh ingredients. They're true to the customer, true to the sandwich. Remember to go to Togo's whenever you're around the Pacific Coast, or look them up online, talk about it, look them up. And so when next time you're here, you should go there. Togos.com, TOGOS.com.
It is a delightful sandwich. I'm a fan of sandwiches in general.
Oh, yeah. Food. Okay, so
maybe that's just because it's almost noon. It's like 11:30, and I usually eat lunch about now. That's probably why thank you for reading that and reminding me that I'm hungry.
Oh, we got dancing on the screen, y'all. Nice.
There we go. London bringing the dance party to the Accesso Showwear Center in Kent, Washington, Seattle adjacent. Thank you for tuning in to the 2019 International WFTDA Playoffs.
Upon review, an insubordination penalty will be issued to the Philly Jammer from the last jam. London will retain their official review for the period.
London getting the bonus penalty. So we will...
7th power jam penalty for London.
And we will roll Rousey forward to jam number 13 as we see Inky Minx with the star. Now, London in a bit of a disadvantage. However, perfect execution of some offense from the line with the blockers doing the job to open the lane for Inky Minx. Only 2 blockers on the track at the start for London. They are now back up to 3. And now coming back to 4 as Kristen Lee is out. So both packs even. And Rousey standing in the penalty box.
This is the 5th of 6 lead jammer statuses being awarded to London.
Now also mentioned on 6 penalties and skating in this jam is Beth Lord. Beth Lord moving forward for some offense, but now... rolling back as Hump Me with the rollback of Rousey. And Rousey evades that and breaks through. That is the initial pass for Rousey, and a cut track penalty being assessed to perhaps Teflon Donna. I see Teflon Donna rolling out. I also see number 7, Kristen Lee, heading out. And a back block call on Rousey. So Power Jam resumes.
3 jammer penalties in a row for Rousey, and a power start coming up for London.
Yes, Inky Minx calls off the jam with 4 points. 2 points up for Philly. Taking us to 175-109. 5.5 minutes to go. Number 4, Delta Strike, taking the jammer star for London.
And Rousey, 3 jams in a row, starting the second one starting from the penalty box.
And 1 blocker from each team in the penalty box. Official review called by Philly.
This official review is brought to you by Left Turn Clothing. Check out leftturnclothing.com for the latest in derby wear prints. And their website is leftturnclothing.com.
All right, going to take a look at some jammer stats now in just a second. As soon as they come up, there we go. So looking on the Philly side, you've got leading your point scorers with 46 is Reptar, followed closely by Herman with 43. On the London side, Jack Attack, 60% lead jammer with 26 points leading their scorers. Trisha Smackinawa close behind with 25, and Beth Lord with the
Philly
19
is contesting
points.
The back block call on their jammer from the last jam. They feel that the blocker moved into it.
All right. Sorry for talking over our ref. I was too busy staring at the stats and not paying attention to what was going on. Beth Lord has 19 points. Now here is a replay of the bump to the infield. This is the call that they're contesting. Did the blocker move in or not? Coming around. Ooh, I am not a referee, so I will not say anything, but I do see people moving. And of course, we don't have a video replay as part of the official review here. I think the WFTD needs to reach out. You know, you got the NFL with the Microsoft Surface thing. Surely there's somebody with a tablet that wants to sponsor official reviews, right? All right, maybe not. Then we'd need 50 more volunteers to carry those tablets around, plus a massive camera crew at every game. Ah, well, it does make it fun for at home because you can go, what? That wasn't a thing.
Yeah, and I like it's like, wait, you didn't catch it the first time? We're going to show you one more time.
That was
well done.
Production team with that replay. That was lovely. We had one yesterday where it was like the was it hands out of bounds or not? And the referee saw it one way and we saw a different on the screen.
Upon review, the call will stand. Philly will not retain their review for the period.
There we go. Again, the eyes on the track see with the eyes on the track see. I do not have the value of someone will gift that immediately and it will be everywhere like, what? And I'll say, I was on the other side of the track. I didn't even see it happen in the first place. All right. Power start for London. Delta Strike moving forward. 3-on-3 in the pack. Philly racing things forward. Delta Strike hopping, trying to stay in bounds, but bumped out just at the end. And pushing, does get past Dramagachi and grabs lead jammer.
6 of 7 lead jams going to London.
And number 7, Kristen Lee, back out of the penalty box. Delta Strike eased out of bounds by Wftda. Wftda pushing, and Delta Strike does get free as Rousey back out of the box and breaks through on the inside edge to complete the initial pass.
Oh, Delta. Oh, taking a knee tap down at turn number 2, right back up.
And Rousey forced out of bounds as well and rolled back behind the pack. Rousey trapped at the corner. Now we're in the part of the track where I can't see anything because it's all through bodies, but Delta Strike finally finding a room on the inside edge to grab 4 more points. Rousey threw for 4 as well.
Just has a great job with the offense. Always in time, like but just going to the penalty box, you did something wrong in that last one.
Dang. Delta Strike looking to the outside. Teflon Donna with the force out and rolling backwards. Russian Bayou and Fitiva at the back of the pack for Philly. Slowing things up.
Look at that. Look at that. Beautiful, beautiful footwork. Mm-hmm. Toe stopping all the way around that edge. Totally legal around that pack. That tripod held her for quite a while at turn number four. But that's an 8-point jam for everyone. 183 for Philly. Ooh, 10 points for London. Yep. Taking them to 119.
Now 2:55 to go in the game. Official timeout being called. As we will sit again, winner of this moving on to play tonight at 8:30 p.m. against the winner of Montreal versus Jacksonville. That game, Montreal-Jacksonville, coming up next right here at 12 p.m. Pacific time. Adjust accordingly. The loser of today's game moves on to play Arizona in the consolation bracket. That will be tomorrow morning at 11 a.m. Pacific, the first game of the day. First day of game of Sparkle Sunday.
Do you have sparkles?
Prepare yourself. I do have some sparkles.
Oh, that's always fun to see.
Yeah.
My jewelry will be my sparkles and my skirt.
There you go. Mm-hmm.
I need a sequins vest, though. The sequins I've seen at this tournament is fabulous.
Yes. It has been quite the show. All right, having another track cleanup moment. And when we come back, we'll have a couple of people set to jam. Herman and number 16, Drac.
So I'll take a moment. This track repair brought to you by Concussion Awareness. Do you know the symptoms of a concussion and the return to play protocol you and your teammates should be following? Visit WFTDA.com/concussions for resources and information of this silent injury. And we'd also like to shout out and give some thank yous to many of our lovely sponsors and contributors. I'll just throw out a few. Girls on Track. Thank you from the WFTDA and all of the staff. Body Breakdown and Gaff Gun. Thank you so, so much for all you do.
Kind of like the Gaff Gun.
Yeah, we can't do it without them.
Can't, exactly. No. So teams in this tournament, of course, playing towards the Hydra, the championship tournament coming up in November in Montreal, Canada. Top three teams from this tournament will head on to play there, and you can get your tickets. You can get your tickets for the 2019 International WFTDA Championships. That's November 15th through 17th in Montreal. Pick them up at WFTDA.com/champs. Lots of fun experiences awaiting you in Montreal. Chicks and Bowls, Shred Sessions, Team Indigenous, team, and the Jewish Roller Derby game. We Are Nation game, Game Without Borders. That's going to be fabulous. We also have many more new experiences that will delight you. Not an event you're going to want to miss. Plus, you get to go to Montreal and who doesn't like that? Get your tickets now before they are gone. WFTDA.com/champs. And, of course, we've got the View Pass, the Hydra package. You can get your viewing passage to watch it right here on WFTDA.tv as well.
You can. I'm looking at Twitter. And so also Debella DeBall of Texas fame. She said she would get me all the sequins I wanted.
Really? Well,
yes.
That's nice. They're going to be, like, airdropped.
Yeah,
drone
right?
Delivery right to the venue tomorrow.
Well, they'll be at champs. I'm hoping to be at champs.
Yes.
I'm going no matter what, working or playing. I want to be there. Let's see.
Excellent.
Yes, let's take a moment. This is from Zero of Hyrule. Take a moment to Beth Lord, how much work she has done in this game. Yes, oof. Hats off.
Yes, Beth Lord has had the star five times passed over. Did start one jam as the because, of course, she picked up a penalty and had to sit over. Is currently sitting, as I mentioned, on 19 points, all post-star pass. And now we are ready to get back to it with number 16, Drac, jamming against number 152, Herman from Philly. And Herman making almost quick work, but then captured by Humpme at the front, but finally does break out to clear the pack as lead jammer. 2:43 to go in the game. Humpme picking up a penalty and heading to the box. Humpme had three penalties in the first six jams. Had not had a penalty since until right now.
Cleaned it up pretty quick.
Cleaned it up very quick. and hump me, or Herman grabbing the 4 points and calling off the jam.
Quick four, holding London to those to 119 from last jam and 187 for Philly. Oh my goodness, this has flown by. Just over 2 minutes left on the game clock. And look who's back. Jack Attack jamming for London. And that will be
Reptar. 501 for Philly. That was London's first scoreless jam since the sixth jam of this half. They were doing a great work. And then Philly had to crush their dreams with that jam. All right, maybe not crush their dreams, but certainly shut them down for one jam's worth. Reptar grabbing lead. As we're under the two-minute mark, the jam clock 1 second off from the period clock. So theoretically, if this jam runs to its conclusion, as London has a timeout to take, we could see a second jam. 4 points up for Reptar. Jack Attack still working on the initial pass. Bumped side to side and then trapped again. V-Deep on the kickstand at the front of the pack. Humpy playing the kickstand and then swinging to the outside to slow down Reptar, but Reptar finding room on the outside and is through for four. That takes Reptar, will now be the leading scorer for Philly, I believe, after that jam as Jack Attack forced out of bounds and rolled back. Reptar. Like, am I out? Huh? Okay, I'm going to just be safe and we'll roll in and continue through.
Doing a little hokey pokey, returning to the back of the pack just to be safe.
Yes.
Jack Attack finally out on her initial pass.
Safety first. Meanwhile, blockers from each team heading to the box. V Diva and number 8008 Gaz for London. 4 points up for Philly. 2 points. For London takes London to 121. Philly now knocking on 200 at 199. And we do have one more jam, at least 24 seconds to go in the game.
That was the biggest jam of the second half for Philly with 12 points and the only double-digit jam for them the second half.
All right, Herman with the star for Philly. Inky Minx jamming for London as the period clock ticking down to 5-4-3. This will be our final jam of the game.
Oh.
Multiplayer block called on Inky Minx. So that will be a power jam for Herman. Lead jammer not assessed yet. Direction of play penalty called on 00 Meryl Stripper from Philly.
Wow.
As Herman pushing towards the front, pack rolling forward. Philly providing some offense, but forced out of bounds as Herman and rolled back by Katie Helvetica Black.
All the way back.
Taking it as deep as possible. And then, like, lowering the boom on V-Diva.
It was like, a windmill. Whoa, it was right. A windmill move to down to the ground.
Mm-hmm.
She's right back up, though.
Yes, back up and regrouping as Inky Minx is in play and through, but lead jammer going to Herman, who immediately calls off the jam.
What a game.
That was quite the game. London with some moments of brilliance and coming back, but Philly able to just weather the storm, hold on, and do what they do well, which is shut down the defense and sit with 199 points, unofficial score, 199 to 121. With that, Philly will move on to the semifinal. Their hopes for the Hydra continue to be alive. And London will slide into the consolation bracket tomorrow at 11 against Arizona. Here's a replay of that final. I believe this will be the grabbing of lead jammer. Oh, nope, that was the penalty. So off we go and roll back.
Yeah, so next up we have Montreal versus Jacksonville. And, I mean, bracket-wise, I mean, who do you choose? We have the number 2 seed versus the number 7 seed. But Jacksonville always surprises you at playoffs. Both these teams actually do great. They've been here many years.
They have, yes. Jacksonville, great game yesterday, 100 beating Ann Arbor 251 to 123. So they're also all warmed up, Montreal. Had a bye yesterday, gets to a nice relaxing day, watch the competition, scope out Jacks. Now they get to play them in about 20 minutes plus a little bit after we clear the track and get everyone out of here. And I believe we're going to throw to we're going to have a trackside interview after these laps from Electra Blue.
So she will be interviewing. Do we know who she's interviewing?
I do not, but we will find out when she gets there. Looking at the final penalty count, only the one foul out. We had Sheldon Scarlett foul out. London did end the game with three players on six penalties. Philly ended the three with two. Your leading scorer for the game was number 501 Reptar. I was like, I think Reptar was in the last jam and got, or next to last jam, picked up some points. 58 total for Reptar. On the London side, leading scorer was with 60 points, Inky, or that's the lead percentage, sorry, with 28 points, Jack Attack pulled that out. So congratulations to both teams, most especially to Philly. Philly, that was a solid defensive game.
It was so fun to watch, so fun to call. It's been a pleasure working with you.
It's been a pleasure working with you as well, Muffin Tumble. Now we will, we're still waiting on our interview as Electra Blue trying to wrangle skaters and get them over to the track. Looking at the rest of our day, so we have our next game, our quarterfinal coming up at noon. That will be Montreal versus Jacksonville. The 2 p.m. game, we head into our consolation bracket, Stockholm versus Queen City, followed by Minnesota and Ann Arbor. And those games will be at 2 p.m. and 4 p.m. And then semifinal fun. Our first semifinal of the game, Denver versus Crime City. Those teams both played and won last night. That's the 6:30 game, Denver beating Arizona at Crime City. Tough game with Rat City, but coming out victorious. And then Philly will play again at 8:30 p.m. tonight, which is, 11:30 on the East Coast?
Yes.
Ooh, Philly fans, nice late night for you guys. We will see them take on the winner, Montreal versus Jacksonville. All right, it's looking like Electra Blue is almost ready. I see that she's got Jail Bars with her and possibly Little Loca. Yes, Little Loca indeed. Perhaps we will get our influence on whatever that specific superpower was they got. Let's go to Electra Blue.
Right. All right. Hi, Electra Blue here. I'm with Loca and Jail Bars, who just won that game. Coming in cold, that was your first game of the tournament. So what did you do yesterday to prepare for today?
We came and we watched the Queen City London game to see who we were playing, and then we just kind of chilled out and, took care of ourselves, like had some good meals and mentally prepared.
So I heard you had a little bit of a scare coming over here. Your plane was hit by lightning? That's got to be something to shake off. Did that affect your mental game a little bit?
I think it just made it heightened our awareness to everything, and we all came off the flight and we're like, that just happened, right? Like, we weren't making that up. So it just like got us like super aware, and we're all like, we're on our toes, we're ready.
You definitely, I think it actually helped you get some lightning under your feet there a little bit, because you were really charged up. You are all charged up. So you have to come back tonight at 8:30 for the second of the semifinal games, and you're gonna be playing the winner of this game. So are you gonna stick around and watch a little bit of this?
Oh, definitely. Yeah.
And so you've been watching both of these teams probably for a little while, too. So what have you been looking for?
Trends, anything we can kind of notice. We're just really all about tuning our gameplay, not really so much worrying about what everyone else is doing. I think keeping like straight with our strategy and doing our game is the most important. And that's been the biggest game changer for us, for sure.
Well, you skate on sport court at home, too. So do you think that kind of gives you a little bit of an edge? Because it takes a little minute to dial in the floor, I think.
Yeah, I think we're used to it a little bit because our home track is sport court, and then we every year at ECDX the court is really similar to this, so we're kind of used to like bringing some wheels and changing it up, and then just used to like how it kind of slides and like grips in different places. It helps a little bit.
And there's actually ice underneath this floor. Yeah. It's a hockey rink. Can you feel that when you're out there?
It's a weird rattle, but it's like a little more hollow than what we're used to, so it's kind of just like we can definitely feel something's different.
Well, it didn't show. You ran away with it the first half. You came in super strong. I feel that momentum's going to carry on. You're going to rest up a little bit. You're going to watch this game, of course. Rest up a little bit. Get that mental rare. Get that lightning. Channel that lightning to come back into your skates again. All right. Well, we'll see them back tonight. They're going to go watch this game for a little bit. Go get your photo op, because I know I took you away from that. Y'all keep watching at noon. We've got coming up right behind us, Jacksonville and Montreal. And they will, the winner of that this game will play Philly tonight at 8:30. So keep watching on WFTDA.TV.